Today, we would like to talk about the NIAID Impact Assessment Program. The name of program is DB4SAI. Michael Pontit, Vachalit, Chow, and I, Atatali. As we know, the noise is an unwanted sound that can affect to our health. For example, some strength it can cause to some extent, so we should to assess the impact of noise that can release into the environment. And this program is the DB4SAI program. Is a software application that predicts the noise level for outdoor industry project, and they can it use scientific principle to predict on-site and surround the facility. It's used computation methodology as defined in the international standard or ISO 9613. The noise level prediction port and data of DB4SAI can be used to provide the input required for assessment of the noise impact in vicinity of new facility, update for planning, regulation, improvement, and public consultation. It calculates the sound propagation in octave band A level, A rating level. The noise level prediction. The noise level prediction methodology consider geometric divergence, atmospheric damping, the height of source and receptor, screen for obstacles such as barrier, building, beam, and so on. And the last one is the gauge absorption. In addition, it's able to consider the site evaluation and topography data, and it compute the barrier effect based on the topography in the natural and topography of natural evaluation contour and man-made barrier. And this product, this produce realistic and accurate the noise level. That assessment for some of area. And the last, the geo-reference noise stimulate port for viewing directly in the Google Earth.
Okay, next I will show you how to use the DB4SAI program. When you open the program, you see the window like this. This is the project panel of the DB4SAI program. The left hand side is the necessary data that you have to input. It starts from the project name. You have to determine your project name. And the most necessary data is the geographical coordinate. Such as north latitude, south latitude, east latitude, and also west longitude. And other information that you have to include in the ground height of this area, there are three functions that you can choose from this program. And another is the parameter of the data of this area that you want to study about. For the right hand side is the result that you want to get for the calculation and evaluation. Next one is on the three bar below is the function that you have to select for the output location and elevation file part. That is, will give you more accuracy for the calculation. This is an example of this result. If you get the right or the true parameter, you will get a beautiful picture like this. And if your data is not suitable, the picture will look not quite good. Okay. Before you start program, you have to setting and the setting panel from the menu bar. From the setting, if you click, you will see like this. The first one is the sort setting panel. It is sort of the sound. You have also to input the geographical coordinate and also the sound power level over here. Next is the solids and custom barrier setting panel. And my friend already said that some building or the mountain can be the obstacle of the sound. You have to edit or input the data to these two boxes. And this is the point of this section setting panel is the point that you want to study. The receiver point that you want to study. This is a contour line setting panel. You see the beautiful color, the most color, the really, really, really colorful bar around here. It will give you the color we show the noise level. How to say, the most hot color will give the really high noise level, and the cold color will give you the low noise level. And another type of the result is the view control setting panel. It will be quite the same with the previous one, but this one will show in the range of low level and high level. After you input all the data you click run function on the menu bar like this. If your webcam run properly, you will see the result will show the DB4 size. Noise level prediction and mapping is complete. Okay, next my friend will show you what can the program can show us.
So on my part, I will talk about what kind of information you can obtain by using this kind of program. So first I will start about the elevation part. By input the parameter of the noise source by the location of the noise source, the point of the receiver noise source, the type of the noise source, you can have the information like this. It tells like how the noise spread differently to the different altitude. And for next one, like by putting the source setting in the very beginning, the people who run this program can easily understand like what kind of noise source they have in their industrial practice, and they can reduce the source accordingly to the type of the source. And so next one, the solid barrier, this program can show how the solid barrier affect the spread of the noise. So in order to like to reduce the noise spreading from the point source to the surrounding area, the industrial practitioner can address the solid barrier by using this program and by adjusting the value in the solid barrier settings. So you can like know how to reduce like what kind of barrier they should put in order to reduce the noise they produce. And for the next one is the combination with the DB4 side with Google Earth. Like by output the result to the Google Earth, you can obtain not only the elevations but also like the how far the noise can travel through distance. This one is combination of the altitude and the distance that the noise can travel. As you can see, different colors represent different level of noise from the source of the noise generation. So next one, this one is only including the distance. So as you can see from the source, like the distance, the noise level reduce as the distance go further from the source. And this one is also another example of how it can affect the distance can affect the noise separation spreading. And you also can combination with the Excel, and you can have something like this. You can see how the the noise effect to different altitude. Like how high they go, they can make how the noise level can affect and how the noise, the effect of the noise can separate and spreading. So the next one is like they also can show how the noise, how the barrier affect the noise traveling. As you can see, there's no, for this example, right, there's no barrier in between the receiver and the noise generation. So you can see that the noise increased from 44.8. But if there's a barrier in between, you can actually reduce the noise to like much lower without the noise barrier. So in conclusion, I would say this program can help the industrial people to optimize and to predict the noise, possible noise pollution they will have in the future, and to know how to control the noise they're going to generate. Thank you.